Lash Legend has one hell of a record of achievement, but Albert Fire is going to have a hands full.
And his opponent, Zion Quinn.
Last week it was Quinn who noted, in the previous match against Wesley, he dominated for all but 3 seconds.
Well, unfortunately for Zion Quinn, those 3 seconds are the most important 3 seconds of any match because his shoulders were pinned against the match and it cost him. So here's the deal. Tonight's your opportunity to put things right. You know this has been running through the mind of Zion Quinn ever since 2 weeks ago when he lost. Fix it tonight.
I want to talk about that matchup for Wesley. He was out to prove he's about more than just heart, but even after that victory, you still see him and you hear him and you can see his eyes right there. He's still angry. I thought a victory for Wesley would make him a little bit happy.
Well, heart is going to take you a long way in this world, and it clearly...
Looking for the 3 seconds again, and whoa, that was close.
Clearly has already for Wesley in his entire career, including that win against Zion Quinn. You mentioned, though, that he didn't look too happy even after victory. It's not just about wins and losses in this game, certainly not for Wesley. It's about finding inner peace. His life over the past few weeks and months has been complete turmoil, okay? It felt a bit better, I'm sure, after beating Zion Quinn. It certainly did not fix everything.
Well, there you see Quinn now turning things around and establishing his dominance early on in this matchup. And for Quinn, he is not a man who likes to be embarrassed. He just landed. Look at the unbridled athleticism for Wesley, but I hear what your point is, because a win doesn't make everything better for Wesley. It doesn't take away or change any of the facts of what has happened over the last several months.
Wesley is still trying to figure out exactly where his compass is pointing. I think he just did a 360 after this moment where he ran straight into a brick wall in the form of Zion Quinn.
Well, wait a minute, Wade. We have huge news just made for later tonight. Bron Breakker will defend the NXT title against Duke Hudson here on NXT.
I got a lot of admiration for Wesley. Doesn't care about the size or strength of opponents. Feels like he can compete with anyone, even if he does have major disadvantages.
Well, Quinn has called Lee's victory somewhat of a fluke. Do you buy into that?
No, wow. Certainly not a fluke, but as we're seeing right now from Zion Quinn, it was not a convincing victory by Wesley by any stretch. Quinn dominated Lee for the entire match, as you mentioned. He also destroyed Wesley about 6 weeks ago to start this thing off the first time they collided. If you were a betting man, you would be banking on Zion Quinn to do the business tonight.
Well, Quinn has admitted he took his eye off the ball for those 3 seconds. Do you think at any point, as we take another look, we talk about the unbridled athleticism, how about the unbridled strength of Quinn? Does he lack focus at times, in your opinion, inside the squared circle?
Well, I'm going to be straight with you. Zion Quinn, to me, at times, tonight even, has looked like he's not really trying. He's staying in control by being bigger, stronger. And now, that lack of focus, lack of taking your opportunities, is potentially going to cost him again.
And now Lee quickly off the kick, scaling to the top, looking to fly. NXT Universe behind Wesley. X marks the spot. Lee picks up another win.
Here is your winner, Wesley.
Oh, man. Count out Wesley at your peril. Zion Quinn just tasted that firsthand. This man is never down, never out. And how the hell can anyone else on the planet pull off a move like this? What do you even call that?
Take another look. Wesley flying through the air. No fluke about this victory tonight. But for a man who's trying to find peace, I'm sure this victory is a little bit sweeter this week on NXT.